Choosing praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Choosing praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
My name is Brother Ikechukwu Idam. I joined the Lord Choosing in the year 2005. And when I joined the Lord Choosing, I had this message of salvation. I repented of my sins, and God granted me genuine salvation. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So I joined the evangelist and was committed doing the work of an evangelist, preaching everywhere, joining evangelist programs. So I continued doing that until a time I went to Cross River State for the same work of evangelism. And after doing that work, God told me that when I come back to Lagos, I should go and see my pastor. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And when I came back, I went to see my pastor. It was not easy for me. But when I was going, somebody just ran to me and said, "Young man, follow me, that he will take me to my pastor." And that was how the pastor saw me and prayed for me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And after that, challenges came. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I was in front of my balcony one day, and behold, I just saw a woman opposite our house where I'm staying in Lagos. And before you know it, the woman just opened her wrapper. Praise the Lord. And the sight was not good. And from there, I started having issues within myself. And before you know it, I went into the scene of masturbation. Praise the Lord. And that, you know, I started having issues, all kind of problems. And when I came to church, I saw our GO in the spirit, in the revelation. My eye was open in the spirit and I saw our pastor. And he used his wrapper and covered his face. I could not see his face again. Praise the Lord. Mm. And that was how my problem started. In fact, anytime our GO visits me in the dream, he's coming for judgment. He's coming to rebuke me. And it was after then I lost my salvation and went neck deep into sin of masturbation, pornography, visiting prostitutes, all kind of evil. So anytime Gio comes to me in the dream, he's to speak a word of judgment. There was a day he came, I saw him in a dream. He said, "Those people that are coming to Lord Choosing and are still living in sin, I command Holy Ghost fire." And fire started burning me in that dream. Praise the Lord. Brethren, it was not easy for me. I started asking God for mercy. Praise the Lord. And when I came to church, it would be like something is pursuing me. I will run out of Lord Choosing. I'll still come back. Brethren, everything was against me. My department people, everybody was against me. Even in my branch, it was all problems. I was having issues with any pastor that come to pastor us in the branch. So I continued in that situation. I didn't know what to do. Practically, I saw another spirit, you know, ruling my life, telling me what to do. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Telling me all kind of things. There was a time this spirit came upon me and told me to buy all kind of things to go and give to a sister who is not my wife, including private wares. Anything he tells me to do, I do it. That was my condition, brethren. I started going from one church to another. Praise the Lord. I went to Redeem. I went to Winners. I went to Liberation City. They are uncountable. But I was still living in sin. But there was this time I saw myself after I went to Redeem. So I knelt down in the spirit. And while the GO was ministering to me in prayer, our pastor appeared and told the GO that I belong to him, that I'm his son. The GO said no, that he's the one God has sent to minister to me. Our GO did not argue with him. He disappeared. Praise the Lord. But there's something that marveled me, brethren. There was a time I went to see the GO of Winners. Praise the Lord. And when I went, I don't just know what came upon me. And I told them that I am led to come and see their GO. So they said, "Who am I that the GO just finished Shiloh, that he can't see anybody?" I told them that I'm a choosing. And because I'm a choosing, that God, even if you don't want to come to office, that God will bring him to come and see me. Praise the Lord. And that was how it happened. Brethren, they said, I can't see the GO. I should better go and see another pastor. So I didn't want to argue with them. As I left, within 3 or 5 minutes, the GO appeared. And they came begging me to come and see the GO. Praise the Lord. But after he laid hand and prayed for me, that life of immorality was still there, masturbation and all kind. I was crying every day. My life was stagnated. There is nothing I put my hand at was. I mean, people hated me. I was idle, no work. It was my sister that was feeding me. And I've been in this condition, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
To cut everything short, brethren. But there was something that happened. One of the days, in the spirit, I was going to see our GO to pray for me. And I saw the Spirit of God appeared. And he told me that as he delivered Job in the hand of the devil, that's how he delivered me, and that nobody can deliver me, that he's the only one that can deliver me. Brethren, I didn't know what to do again. Finally, I went to Winners again, and recently they ordained us as a pastor, associate pastor, part-time pastor. But as I was here, I didn't have joy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I didn't have joy. I was sitting here living a life of masturbation, and I saw myself in the spirit serving an idol, a strange god. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And every day was evil dream, evil dream. No matter how I pray, once I sleep, evil dream will come to minister to me. That has been my condition. Praise the Lord. So I kept asking God, what do I do? Praise the Lord. And God told me one day that I need a solid altar. Praise the Lord. I say, which one is solid altar again? I've almost, you know, went all through the churches and my situation didn't improve. Again, he said, I need an altar where fire is burning. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I should go to the other side for me to have an eternal salvation of my soul. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And later on, when I knew that God was telling me to return back to Lord choosing, was a day I had a voice that said, when the man of suit touches you, you forget all your problems. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That was how I left Abuja, because I have left Lagos and went to Abuja. I left Abuja on Saturday to come to this very place. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And when I came, I was watching Choosing Television, and our GO ministered, you know, on salvation message. After listening to that salvation message, I gave my life afresh to Jesus. And when I slept, I saw myself, I was placed on top of a rock, and light covered me. Praise the Lord.
Oh,
and after that encounter in the dream, that appetite of masturbation ceased.
Uh-huh.
That evil dream, I have not been seeing it.
Hey.
And
God will choose him.
I have not been seeing that evil dream that I've been tormenting. Even my serving that idol, I've not seen it again. So this testimony is more like a restitution. So I've come to ask the God of Chosen to have mercy upon me, because one of the days we normally have a boy say tarry night. That was 2007. God told us that he has a covenant of mercy with our GO. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And that is only his mercy that can deliver me. So I have come to ask God for mercy and his servant, because in that condition, everything I was preaching, I was turning against it. I turned against this church, speaking against what they are preaching. I spoke so many things. So I've come to ask God to have mercy upon me and let this salvation he has given to me to be permanent. And that our GO and the Lord choosing should equally forgive me and take me as one of their brothers. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I equally want to make a special appeal to our GO. I don't even want to go to his office because of what I had before I left Abuja. That I only need a touch. I only need a touch from him and I'll forget all my problems. Because of this issue, there are so many problems which I cannot recount now. But I don't know whether I can be given an opportunity just for our GO, just to say a word and give me a touch. That is what I need before I go back to Abuja. Praise the Lord, brethren.
Hallelujah. Well, inasmuch as you have made your restitution and you have said you are sorry, and the mind of our Jew is that from the day you did the evil, he has forgiven you.
Amen.
All he needed you to do is to say you are sorry. And I'm very sure that whether Jew will touch you physically or not, you will be touched by his word today. Whether Jew will touch you physically or not, as Jew comes to pulpit, you will be touched.
Amen.
Because if our Jew should begin to touch everybody one by one because of the matter, it will be wearing him down. But just stay under his ministration, the word from his mouth will touch you.
Amen.
And that yoke will be broken in your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I hope we have learned a lot of lessons from this testimony. Because one lesson that I can learn is, when you see somebody speaking against choosing, it is because they are committing a sin that choosing is preaching against. That is why they are speaking against choosing. So such people, you need to show compassion to them and pray for them that God will deliver them from the spirit that is living inside them. That is one lesson that I can learn from this testimony. And like I said, our pastor's mind is that you are forgiven once you have come back safe and sound. And another lesson we can learn from this testimony is, a choosing will never be lost. No matter how far you go, you must surely come back. I think that is a word of comfort for us. All the backsliders from the church, our pastor keep praying that God should recover them. This is one of the answers to that prayers. Let's clap unto God and appreciate him.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to pray for my Gio, that this God have entered into a covenant of mercy, praise the Lord, with him. That covenant of mercy will be speaking in the life of every choosing, wherever they are, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name I pray.
Amen. Let's clap unto God and appreciate him. The last testifier for today.